An avid rider on Kora, Ruchika Agrawal scored a good 99.82 percentile in CAT 2018. Currently a student at Faculty of Management Studies FMS, she converted both IIM Bangalore and FMS. Let's get to know Ruchika a little better. Hi Ruchika.
Hi.
From BIT Sindri to Tata Consultancy Services to FMS Delhi, you've been places. Tell us something about your journey.
So from small towns of Bihar and Jharkhand to corporate world full of engineers to FMS Delhi, I believe that my journey is no less than a roller coaster ride for me. And being from a small town, it has its own set of advantages and disadvantages. On one hand, I faced opportunity crunch. Like, we had limited number of schools available. We did not have coaching facilities available at that point in time. But on the other hand, it helped me in learning to adapt to the surroundings quickly. It also helped me in learning to manage a limited amount of resources. And not only that, I realized the importance of opportunities in my life. And I think that is the major drive behind every decision that I have taken till now throughout my journey. And I have tried to maintain a steep learning curve throughout.
99.82 percentile in one shot? Wow! We want to know, in fact, people want to know, how did you manage to do that?
It was not in one shot. I took CAT once before also. In 2015, I took CAT and I managed to get a decent percentile of 97. And I got a call from some of the new IIMs and I even decided to join a new IIM. But due to some reasons, I dropped out.
Why did you decide to drop out of a new IIM? Because that is a tag.
Yeah, absolutely right. As I told you that I have always understood the importance of opportunities in my life. And you know, when I got this opportunity to study in an IIM, it was a big thing for me. I grabbed this opportunity with both hands without even giving a second thought to it. But when I joined IIM, then that new IIM, the reality hit me hard. I got to know about a lot of things. I realized that I had no clarity towards my thought. I had no clarity towards my career goal. I was just there for a prestigious tag, a degree, and some lucrative offers. And the added pressure of the huge sum of loan that I had taken made me rethink my decision every day. And after days of dilemma, I finally decided to drop out of IIM and leave the tag for which many aspire.
Now that you have 2.5 years of industry experience, where does MBA fit into your career aspirations?
As I mentioned that I dropped out of IIM in 2016, it was somewhere in July, as far as I remember. After dropping out, that decision of mine invited a lot of criticism. People started doubting my decisions, my capabilities, and because of that, I went into a kind of depression for 3 months. My parents supported me a lot and I decided to divert my mind, and therefore I joined TCS. While I was working there, I spent most of my time on introspection. It was then when I realized that what I wanted to do in my career, I wanted to defeat my own failure. Since I mentioned that a lot of ups and downs were there in my life because of correct and incorrect decisions that I have taken. So I wanted to counsel students, especially of small towns, and to help them in deciding their career path. So I wanted to start something in counseling and motivation sector. And I think that I realized that MBA will provide me a very good opportunity to take a step further towards this goal of mine.
In 2018, you converted both FMS and IIM Bangalore. How different were the two interviews?
So IIM Bangalore was my first interview of the season. And both the interviews were very different. In IIM Bangalore's interview, before the interview, we needed to submit a statement of purpose. It was of around 600 to 650 words. It included every aspect of my life, starting my background, to my education, to my work experience, to everything. So the interview mainly revolved around every aspect of my life, starting from tell me about something about yourself, then about my education, about my expectation from that course, and it was a long interview. As far as I remember, it was of 20 to 25 minutes. And talking about FMS interview. So FMS interview was a short, was of a shorter duration. I think 8 to 10 minutes. And it also started with tell me something about yourself. But then they had 1 minute for extempore round. And after that, they asked me some questions like why MBA? Why do you want to join FMS? Have you converted other B schools also? Because when the interview of FMS happens, the results of all the other B schools, most of the other B schools are out by then. So they also asked me some GK questions like rapid fire. So that was the main difference that I can remember.
Okay, were there any similarities also that you found?
Yeah, there were some similarities. Like I mentioned that both the interviews had the question, tell me something about yourself. So both of them started with the same question. And apart from that, I think one major similarity was that they were trying to build pressure and they were trying to check whether the candidate is able to handle that pressure or not. So in the Bangalore's interview, they were doing a lot of follow-up questions. Whatever answer I was giving, they were asking the question following up the same, following up that particular answer. And it was a rapid fire. So they were trying to build the pressure. And again in FMS interview, they were asking a lot of GK questions. So back to back, they were asking a lot of GK questions out of which I think two or three I could not answer also. So I think they were checking a lot of things like confidence and ability to handle pressure. So those were the common things in both the interviews.
Was there any peculiar moment that you clearly remember from each of these interviews?
I don't think that there was any peculiar movement. It was just that in IIM Bangalore interview, I was quite nervous. It was the first interview of the season. And I remember that I was walking restlessly outside that room. And I knew that this interview of mine was not going to decide my career, but it was going to decide my confidence level for my FMS interview. It could have made or it could have broken my confidence before FMS interview. So that was one thing that I remember.
FMS over IIM Bangalore is a very big decision. What motivated you to choose FMS?
So first of all, it was not FMS over IIM Bangalore for me. It was always only and only FMS for me. When I decided to take CAT in 2018, I even told my parents that I want to join only one B school, and that was FMS. So rather telling you why I chose FMS over IIM Bangalore, I'll tell you why I chose FMS. I believe that choice is a luxury and everyone cannot afford it. FMS can provide me with the luxury of that choice. It can provide me that freedom to make some fearless choice for myself. As I mentioned, I want to start something of my own in education and counseling sector. So somewhere in the back of my mind, that financial burden will be there if I'll have a huge sum of loan. If I'll take a huge sum of loan. And that freedom I can get in FMS. I'll not have that monetary restrictions in the back of my mind. Apart from that, there were some other factors also that helped me in deciding about my aim, that was FMS. So first of all, the smaller batch size. I believe that the smaller batch size can provide me a wonderful opportunity of an unparalleled peer-to-peer learning. Apart from that also, I read somewhere, I think on Quora, about the experiential learning. Like faculties encourage students to come up with their own case, and sometimes they tell students to do a survey in the nearby local markets like Kamla Nagar market. I was amazed by this fact of this practical exposure of this experiential learning, and I so wanted to experience this. And last but not the least, I was amazed by the fact that here people like faculties, students, everybody tries to inculcate a feeling of giving back to society. So even before coming to FMS, I was allotted a mentor for GDPI and extempore round. So she was from Vihan club, that is a social service club of FMS, and I read a lot about Vihan. So they organize a lot of events like Pratidan and a silent auction, in which they collect the funds and then they donate all the funds to the blind association. And not only that, even professors encourage us to visit NGOs and help them in their activities. So because of those things, I really wanted to join FMS. And so I decided to come here.
FMS is known as the Red Building of Dreams, as it's there on your sweatshirt also today. What is the dream that you see in this red building?
As I entered FMS, I could clearly see my dream of starting something in counseling and motivation sector coming true. I could clearly see me helping millions of other students in fulfilling their dreams. I could clearly see FMS providing me a lot of opportunities, not only theoretically but also practically. So I think it is really the red building of my dreams.
Given that this is a non-residential MBA program, how does that affect you?
People look at this as a disadvantage because FMS does not have the residential facility. But I personally look at this as an advantage for me. It helps me in learning management and personal life too. So here I get to learn how to manage and arranging my own groceries, how to arrange for my laundry, for my food. And not only that, we live here in an unprotected environment. So it instills a sense of responsibility also. As far as academic part is concerned, I think it doesn't affect much because people here live in a radius of 1 or 2 kilometers around the campus. And for me, it is really fun because we get to do our assignments and projects while having dinner at someone's flat. So that is the best part for me.
FMS has a small campus, while on the other hand, IIM Bangalore has state-of-the-art facilities and everything one dreams of. Has this fact ever bothered you?
I don't think that this fact ever bothered me because FMS is a part of Delhi University. And as we know that Delhi University has a huge campus, so students can avail facilities of Delhi University here. Therefore, I think that this fact never bothered me much.
We have heard numerous times that life at B school is very hectic. How do you deal with that pressure?
Yeah, life here is hectic at times. So what I try to do is I prioritize the things based on my interest. And whenever I'm stressed out, I try to listen to songs because I'm inclined towards music since my childhood. I've also taken training in vocal classical music. So that is one thing that helps, that acts as a stress buster for me. And to talk about competition, the competition here is mostly positive. So I think that music as well as setting my priorities for me, these two things here helps me in dealing with the pressure as well as the competition.
Have you ever considered or thought of going back to IIM Bangalore, or if that was a right decision that you made at that point of time?
So if I'll again go back at that point in time, I will choose FMS all over again.
We see that you answer CAT-related queries on your blog on Quora. What motivated you to start answering those queries?
When I was depressed and I was preparing for CAT, the answers of some of the great articulators helped me at that point. I used to read a lot of interview experiences of different people, and that actually helped me in my preparation. So when I got an opportunity to share my interview experience, I thought that I will do that. And starting from IIM Bangalore interview experience, I started writing on Quora in March, last week of March 2019. And that was the major motivation behind me writing on Quora. I wanted to share my experiences and help the CAT aspirants in their preparation.
Would you want to become a writer in the near future then?
I think that I would like to pursue writing as a hobby or as a medium to share my experience and help students.
What is that one piece of advice that you would like to share with the current CAT aspirant?
I was getting consistently poor percentiles in my mocks in VARC, which was a huge barrier between me and my goal. But I tried working, I kept on working hard. And my determination not only helped me in securing a seat at FMS, I got rank 1 based on the composite admissions course in the final merit list. So I would like to advise the CAT aspirants that never stop practicing. If you will try, you might fall, but you will definitely not succeed if you'll not even try. So that is the one piece of advice that I would like to give to the CAT aspirants.